Hello, 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 my friends. Crack that smack, yo. Desert Eagle Kenny. All you wonderful people. Hope you guys are ready to cook some more cookies today. Hopefully I'm loud enough this time. I tested it a couple times. I think the levels are good. You guys ready to bake some cookies? I was... Welcome to the party. Hopefully this thing isn't in the way. I don't think my chat thing's in the way. So I got all my stuff here. We're going to do cookies again. I wrote down my recipe so I don't have to look at my phone again, which kept turning off, which annoyed me a lot. But let's get the oven pre-baked, pre-heated, 350. I'm a little out of it. I couldn't wake up this morning. My gosh, I went to bed early last night, so I'd be in good shape today. And apparently that made it even worse to me waking up today. Last time it took us an hour. I'm going to hope we could do this a little under an hour, but I don't know. It's hard for me to bake and talk and all do all this stuff at the same time, so... Sound seems good. Perfect. Great. You know, I was thinking, as I was, like, putting all this stuff together, I was like, who was the first person who just saw all this stuff and was like, I'm going to make cookies out of it? There had to have been some long process, but, like, to just flour and random pieces of stuff, who looked at all that and thought, I'm going to create the most wonderful piece of food ever invented? I don't know. So let's get started. Let's get the dry ingredients here. 1.5 cups of flour. I'm hoping next time we do this, we can do something like the cookie cake. I just need to get a few more ingredients for that. I just wanted to do the cookie this time because I ran out of cookies. So I figured we'd make the cookies again one more time. It started with simple bread and people added stuff to it. At some point, someone made a cookie. Well, whoever added chocolate chips is my hero, I have to say. All right, so 1.5 cups of flour. Whoever was the first person who added chocolate chips, that's the best person. You're buffering a lot? Let me go make sure I'm not dropping frames. Hold on a sec, I'll be right back. Dropping frames, so it must be on your end, I think. Someone made a pact with Satan, they made cookies via that, and we're still see the outcome. A pact with Satan. Oh my god. Yeah, it looks like it's on your end, Desert Eagle. Sorry. Hopefully it'll work itself out. Okay, let's see here. Alright, there's plenty of flour. And last time I used 2 eggs when the recipe only called for 1 egg. I'm thinking of trying 1 whole egg with 1 egg white this time and see how that works out. Okay, so that is flour done. And let's see, baking powder and baking soda is each a 1/2 teaspoon. Teaspoon is the smaller one. I have a thing for this, don't I? 1/2 teaspoon, 1 teaspoon, 1/4 teaspoon, 1/2 teaspoon. All right. You're gonna get some food. Be right back. All right, Desert Eagle. Is this making you hungry? All right. Baking powder, baking soda. 1/2 teaspoon of these things. I washed all my stuff, so hopefully all my stuff is good and clean. Okay, so that's 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. And then 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Gotta get salt in our cookies. Salt in our FTL run, salt in our cookies. Salt in our life. You know, salt brings flavor. Salt brings flavor. You were laying in bed listening to my computer fan hum with cobwebs. Then from the depths of his dusty core, I smelled cookies baking. It was so enchanting, it levitated me from my slumber and into my chair where I found you. The mastermind behind the cookies. Well, what's up, man who stands? I didn't know I was so magical, but I'm glad to hear it. That is a great story. Oh my god, 12 months in a row, man who stands. Thank you for your continued randomness. Thousands of cookies later, and I still love you. Sorry, I had to pour out the salt over the sink. Don't want to waste salt because, you know, it's not like I don't have a ton of it. Man, thank you so much. You've been one of the greatest supporters of the stream, Andrew Stans. I really appreciate that. Idea for the Pact with Satan. Cookie dough gives you salmonella poisoning and tastes delicious. And what's the Pact with Satan? I don't know. That's what it is. Okay. Amazing. So that's teaspoons. Okay, so that's all that stuff. We're whisking this stuff together. Baking powder, baking soda, salt, and flour. So we're going to whisk. We're going to whisk away. This is me whisking. Seems weird that you only whisk this one part. They use many words in these recipes. Whisk, mix, cream together, fluff. I have a feeling this is just all different ways of saying stir stuff around with a spoon, you know? I feel like a lot of fancy words for this kind of the same thing. All right, so that should be all hopefully well whisked together. Okay, so now we mix together coconut oil, sugars until lightly fluffy, add egg and vanilla and beat until well combined. Okay. So this is coconut oil, sugars. And again, here's the awesome mixer that Shogi got us the last time we did the cookies baking. Get this in here. Okay. So coconut oil and sugars. So what's the amount we got? Let's do the sugars first and the coconut oil last, I guess. Let's do half cup. Crap, I didn't write down how much regular sugar. Damn it. Hold on a sec. Let me go look at my recipe real quick. I screwed up. I left off an ingredient. I left off the granulated sugar. Who needs sugar when all you need is salt? If I put a quarter cup of salt instead of sugar, I'm pretty sure these would be the worst chocolate chip cookies of all time. Pretty sure. Okay, so quarter cup of granulated sugar, which I need my quarter cup. Oh, where did I put my quarter cup measuring thing? Quarter cup. Where'd it go? That's half cup. Oh my god. I'm losing it. Okay, I don't know what I did with quarter cup, so we do 2 1/8. I am an NA math person. Oh, and I grab a quarter cup. I thought that was the eighth cup. Okay, whatever. I'm bad at finding stuff. Why are cats throwing it all the time if their livers can filter out salt? I don't know what you're even talking about. Okay, so let's go with half a cup of brown sugar. Is that right? Half a cup of brown sugar, yep. We're doing more chocolate this time, by the way, guys. Extra chocolate. Delicious brown sugar, which has pieces of other darker brown stuff with the light brown stuff, which always looks funny to me. But welcome back, there's Eagle. Wow, you quack, you lucky duck. What? Okay. Who needs sugar when all we need salt? Okay, all right, let's see here. Let's get, so that's the brown sugar. We need granulated sugar, 1/4 cup, which is right here. I actually have a cutting board this time because I got a chocolate bar that we're gonna cut up to add to our chocolate, like double the amount of chocolate. Okay, so that's 1/4 cup of just regular white granulated sugar. Do I have a cookie cutter? I do not have a cookie cutter. I'll be cutting the chocolate bar with a knife is what I'll be doing. Already rolled enough cookies for me, Desert Eagle. Okay. Let's see here. So then we need the coconut oil. So this is coconut oil instead of butter is what we're doing. And coconut oil, I need 1/2 cup. So I'm going to use a spoon to scoop this out. Spoon for the coconut oil. Which this stuff is so weird. It's like lard or something. Which I guess you could probably use lard instead of butter too, I'm guessing. I'm going to need more coconut oil for the next time I do this, I think. Okay. This stuff looks gross. But the cookies were great. I don't know, have any of you guys used coconut oil for making things before? I mean, not that I make stuff that often, but okay, I think that's a good amount. I think that's a good full 1/2 cup there. Get it all in there. Okay, I got all the 1/2 cup things I need, brown sugar, coconut oil, yes. Okay, good point, you'd rather eat oat cookies than die of starvation, but only just. Okay, amazing. Alright, so we are mixing together coconut oil and sugars until lightly fluffy, and then we add egg and vanilla after we mix these together. So let's get this mixing. Chips out of the way. Okay, these are an awesome mixer here. Try to do this where you guys can see what I'm doing. For anyone who actually cares. Does that look light and fluffy? I think that's light and fluffy. That's our light and fluffy sugars and stuff. Should add some Snecco oil to those cookies. Snecco oil. I don't know what flavor Snecco oil is, so you have to see what you're doing as you can hear it. Yeah, it's super loud. All right, so then we add egg and vanilla. So how much vanilla is it? It is vanilla, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. A whole teaspoon? Okay. Seems like a lot, but okay. Hopefully I wrote down all these ingredients correctly. Okay, well that's a lot of vanilla. Well, that was a heaping teaspoon, an overflowing teaspoon. It's a confusing flavor. Sneco oil is a confusing flavor. I believe that. All right, so like I said, I did 2 eggs last time. I'm gonna do an egg and an egg white this time. I'll do one whole egg and one egg white. Which, to do the egg white, do a cool thing I saw on other cooking shows where you just kind of move the egg yolk back and forth while the white goes in there. And hopefully, we'll do that. Hopefully I won't want the other rest of the yolk. That was my one cooking skill. Let's see. Okay, let's see here. So we wanted to beat these together, which I think we're just gonna mix. Again, I don't know the difference between beating, mixing, and other things. Beating, mixing, fluffing, creaming. Just gonna do this. Okay, and then we're gonna add the dry ingredients. There we go. Okay, and let me mix this a little bit better here. Need Pie Boy, the professional cook, to tell us how to the difference between beating and all these other things here. Okay, so we're gonna add the dry ingredients. Hey, what's up, Teal? You won the lottery at work today? What does that mean? What does winning the lottery at work do for you? Got a bottle of South African Red with me home today. Is that a wine? Okay, nice, grats. Sure, I'm spilling some of these ingredients here. The wine lottery. You won the wine lottery. Okay. The wine lottery. Not as good as the money lottery. Okay. I'm hoping using less egg here will not make this too dry. But I think it might be good. Okay, so there's our cookie dough. I think it's good. Let me give it a taste here. Yeah, it's good. It's a little less liquidy than last time since I used a little less egg this time. Turn off the vibrator, geez. Hey. How can you make good cookies without a vibrator, okay, Kenny? It's just required. Ask any baker or woman who makes cookies. Vibrators make the best cookies. Okay. That's true. That is true. The more you vibrate it, the better it is, man. Okay. Okay, I think that's a good batter. We're gonna add the chocolate chips after I chop up the chocolate bar. And here you guys go. You wanna licks the mixing spoon. Turn your hands with the same thing. Make sure you trim your nails first. Okay, it's getting really bad. This is a kid's cookie string, guys. Men can use cookie vibrators too. You know they're gonna be good cookies if you're enjoying the batter off the egg beater thingies. I probably shouldn't do that while talking about vibrators. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's get the. Okay, I don't need this anymore. So I got a semi-sweet Ghirardelli baking chocolate bar, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just cut this up into like chunks. And we're gonna do this plus the chocolate chips for extra chocolatey goodness, is what we're gonna do. This is not for kids. But Kenny, you're 12. Remember, you're 12. This stream is for you, Kenny. Are these the GG Cookie Time cookies? They are. They are. I will be using these for GG Cookie Times for as long as they last. These last ones lasted about 2 weeks. So, look at that. So, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna chop these up with a knife, make little chunks and slivers. Chunks and slivers of chocolate goodness. If I can find a knife. There we go. It's not bittersweet chocolate. No, I made sure. I looked at it like three times to make sure it was semi-sweet. So, no bittersweet chocolate for us here. As you can see from my knife skills, I'm definitely not a professional. Just kind of chopping this up. Probably looking for chunks like, like that size or like that size right there. Just small little chunks. Chocolate, man. Smells good just chopping it up. Release your chocolatey goodness to me. If it becomes like really small slivers, I'm okay with that too, because that just kind of infuses the cookies with chocolate, which is amazing. Still works if you hold it the wrong way. Okay, that's how you use a knife. Hey, if Pie Boy says it must be right, Pie Boy is the professional. And using this means I can use a few less chocolate chips, I'd say, too, because we'll have chunks, plenty of chunks. Pie Boy is the professional. Oh, Shogi here? Okay, let's see here. How are we doing here? How are we doing? I basically make them about the same size as chocolate chips, is what I do. No two big giant chunks. Okay, cool. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna slide all this stuff right into the batter here. Probably a more professional way of doing this. Actually, I don't want to do that. I'm just going to put it in there with my hands here. This is going to be very chocolatey. I make very chocolatey chocolate chip cookies. That's a lot of chocolate. You could see covering with chocolate. And the recipe calls for a whole cup of chocolate chips, but I'm going to put. I think I'm just gonna do a half a cup since I put a whole baking bar in there, so. Really chocolatey. Why don't you just make a damn chocolate cookie. I mean, let's be honest, you care less about the batter and more about the chocolate. You know, you're joking, but I'd do it, man. I would do it. Use a knife like that, but upside down, and you cut your hand off. Crack that, Smackio. That sounds about like what would happen there. All right, so let's do just a half a cup of chocolate chips here. Or 2/4 cups, I guess. And you're not wrong, Shogi. I do a lot of chocolate. You are right. This is probably too much. You know it's the right amount of chocolate when you use your spoon, get a cookie, and you can't see the dough for all the chocolate. That's when you get to the right chocolate level. So, there will be a chocolate with cookie flavor, not cookie with chocolate. Okay. All right, let's see if I mix this, if I can see any batter in it. Because, yeah, that's a lot of chocolate chips. It's going to be great, though. Oh, yeah. Chocolate to dough level is looking beautiful. Chocolate to dough level looks great to me. I don't know what you guys are talking about. I could totally see dough. You know, here and there, there's little bits of dough in there. Okay. All right, I'm gonna do what we did last time, which is put it in the fridge while I get the sheets all ready. Just chill the dough for a bit, so it's a little less, liquidy, I guess would be the word. Next stream, can we get peanut butter chocolate chip cookies? I don't know. I love peanut butter, but if I'm gonna have chocolate chip cookies, I just want chocolate usually. Let me wash my hands here. Next time I do this, I'll probably do the chocolate chip cookie cake that we have a recipe for. Makes you feel better you don't lick your fingers when you're cooking at work? Well, it would make me feel better if I was going to your work to eat. So I guess it makes me feel a little better. Okay. So we got our cookie sheets here. Let me move this stuff out of the way. Get our parchment paper on the things here. Chill the dough. I would never eat a hot cookie. Why you add chili to it? That sounds like a weird thing. But I think I've heard of people doing like spicy cookies and stuff. That's not my type of cookie. Definitely no spicy cookies here. Yeah, Spectre, I use coconut oil instead of butter. Instead of butter or lard. If you type !! recipe, it'll bring up the link for the recipe we're using, which uses coconut oil. Okay. Coconut oil instead of butter, basically. Oh, my chat just went away. There it is. You can't join today's stream, you'll have to play some DD. May the doors be with you. All right, Pie Boy. Enjoy your Dungeons & Dragons, my friend. For a second, I was going to say Darkest Dungeon, but that's not what you're doing. But thanks for stopping by, man. We'll see you later, dude. Later, dude. As long as that'll kind of stay. All right, I think that'll work. Okay, and may the doors be with you, also with you, sir. Okay, I think that is everything. Let me let that chill just a little bit longer while I clean up this sugar that is just on my stove, really, that's heating up. Apparently my mixer flung some sugar around. Okay. Okay, all right, let's see here. I think we're ready to scoop this stuff here. All right, okay. And I also want to make smaller cookies this time because they were really huge last time. Each cookie was like a double cookie. So I'm going to do smaller. I'm not sure exactly what size I want to do here. I think smaller might be better in this case. Smaller cookies with lots of chocolate in them sound very good. Bigger is better. Normally I would agree in cookies, but the cookies I made last time were huge, just ginormous. And every time I had a GG cookie time, I felt like I was eating three cookies. So I want to make them a little smaller. I'm already feeling like I'm a little fatter than I want to be, so let's make smaller cookies so we have smaller portions. You know, you gotta watch your girlish figure, right, guys? Gigantic cookie feels amazing, man. Well, that's what the cookie cake is gonna be. The cookie cake will basically be a big giant cookie, so we'll save the giantness for the cookie cake when we do that, maybe in a couple weeks or something. Hey, what's up, League of Pirate? How are you doing, my friend? So, slightly smaller cookies this time. And we'll probably actually get 24 if we do this, whereas last time we got like 20 cookies or something. I may be doing too small of cookies, but we'll see. I might do one like big giant one at the end or something. Why not make a couple small ones and a couple bigger ones? So if you feel like you got a great win, then you can have a massive one. So depending on how good of a win depends on the size of cookie I eat, I will probably do one or two big ones on the other sheet where I have more room. It's not a bad idea, Quack That Smacked You. Not a bad idea. Have different sizes of cookies. Okay, a couple of these are really tiny, so let's augment them a bit. Give them a chocolate chip infusion implant. Okay, that's pretty good. That's got some different sizes there, but here's one sheet of eventual cookies. Those are cookie balls, Omega Lull. They are cookie balls. They will flatten down into cookies. Into actual cookies. Be amaze balls. From cookie balls to amaze balls. They look delicious already. When I visit, can we make them and eat them together? Sure, Spectre. Where do you live again? You're somewhere up north in the U.S., aren't you? I can't remember where you are. You're about to buy Rand a cookie sheet because you can deal with the bat. You can't deal with the baking pan. Hey, I have a cookie sheet. I just don't have two. So it's in memory of making a cookie cake using it in the cake pan. All right. You're from the Middle East. Oh, okay. Well, I was way off. I was way off. Do you eat chocolate chip cookies in the Middle East? Or do you have like some weird spicy cookie? Like somebody was talking about a chili cookie. Hopefully you have good chocolate chip cookies over there. I've never been to the Middle East, so. Okay. kind of like this, making more smaller cookies than less bigger cookies. Okay. Right. Oh man, these are gonna be good. I have a feeling these are gonna be even better than the last batch, guys. Even better. Okay. Okay, I have more cookie dough than I have room on these sheets, so what am I gonna do? I guess I make a couple big giant wall cookies here at the end? I don't know. I made my cookies too small, apparently. I can't fit them all. I need another cookie sheet from Shogi, I guess. Make a cookie skyscraper. Hey, what's up, Scaperio? I don't know what a cookie skyscraper is, but I feel like I'd be a fan. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add... Okay. All right. I think I'm going to do something weird. This is going to make some of these cookies connect together, but I'm going to just put some more in the middle here. We're going to have some connected cookie, maybe not a cookie skyscraper, but a cookie pentagon or a cookie pie or something. Raw cookie dough for breakfast feels good, man. Feels fat, man, maybe? The Human Centipede Cookie Edition. All right. This is going to be kind of weird. These cookies are all going to connect to each other. It'll be a cookie... I don't know. Be like The Fly with Jeff Goldblum. Chocolate Chip Cookie Edition. Okay, all right. Now let me give you a tip. Usually when you do chocolate chip cookies, you don't want to put them all right next to each other like that. So these ones will probably all be nice and separated. These ones are all going to, like, cook down and become one big giant cookie. So you guys said you wanted a big giant cookie. Well, this whole half of the sheet is going to be a big giant cookie. So that's for you guys. Alrighty, so we preheated the oven to 350. Bake 7 to 9 minutes. How's it do it? I'm going to put my timer on 7. And then we'll check on them then. Oh my Jesus. You can cut them if they melt together? Yeah, I got a knife. I can do that. Or I just keep it as a big giant cookie and eat the mega cookie. As Mr. Top Hat Cat says, who wouldn't want to eat a mega cookie? Seriously. All right, so I'm going to kind of clean up as I do it. You guys can see what I'm looking at chat on here. You wish you could choke on a big cookie. Oh my God, that's wrong. Wrong on so many levels. I'm gonna clean as we cook, or clean as you go, as they say on like Top Chef and stuff. Okay. All right, so we have our cooling sheets, which are basically other tins that you're supposed to make cakes with and stuff. I have too small of a kitchen. Cooling racks, thank you, cooling racks. Not cooling sheets, cooling racks. Like bear racks from StarCraft. Damn it. Too much crap, not enough room. Why is my apartment not a professional cooking studio? Seriously. to complain to my apartment. You are not a professional cooking studio like I was paying for. Replace the living room with a kitchen. Your toilet room is bigger than your kitchen. Well, thanks for making my kitchen feel inadequate, Kenny. Thanks for making my kitchen feel inadequate. How much does it cost, since you apparently only make $40 a month in Russia, you know? It costs $1 per square foot. You have really cheap prices there if you can afford it on your paycheck, sir. Do you have debit credit card if you get free Amazon Prime sub here for more cookies? Thanks for advertising for me, Scaperio. Appreciate that. Just have a kitchen house where you wake up and can simply start baking. You know, I know that me doing this baking stream makes it look like I cook all the time. I hardly ever cook anything. Like, this is the first time I've cooked since the last time I baked on stream, which was 2 weeks ago, so. Appearances are deceiving here. Start lucid dreaming, you can have the biggest kitchen in the world. Okay. Let's see. Oh man, those cookies are gonna bake together. It's gonna be a weird X-Man cookie. Do a boiling potato stream. Boiled goose. Oh my god, boiling potato stream. Need a Italian food cooking stream with Rand now? Well, the other thing I cooked recently was I made chicken fettuccine alfredo, and I did make the sauce from scratch, so I could do that one night. I was thinking of maybe making some of the fettuccine on Sunday, since after my church job I don't want to do anything, so I could maybe do a... What did I do? I did fettuccine alfredo with chicken, so... So, I could do that. I could possibly do that. Show how an amateur makes crappy Italian with Rand. Crappy Italian food with Rand. Okay. Oh, man, these cookies look good, man. They're looking even better than last time. Why? Because extra chocolate. So, Kenny, you got a funny story. You decided to skip work yesterday, and guess what? What? Is it about boiled potatoes, Kenny? Does this story involve any boiled potatoes? Guess what? So you're just trying to get everybody to go, what? Tell me more. Tell me more about this story, Kenny. Inquiring random minds want to know. The effing bus overrided 3 people to death on your job bus station. Holy crap. Overturned? Like, did the bus flip? Or did, like, what happened? Okay, so the bus flipped. Holy crap. That's not funny. That's terrifying, Kenny. I feel like funny. There's a video. Of course there's a video. Oh, my God. Oh, man. Those cookies are all baking right up next to each other. I also wanted to cook these a little longer this time so that they were a little less squishy. You would have preferred a boiled potato story? Yeah. Oh my god, Link. Oh god. You want to link the video? How morbid is this? Because I don't want to get in trouble for this being linked in my chat. Maybe PM people who want that link, because I don't know that I want that video linked in my chat. That sounds a little too Reddit real right there. It's a little too real for me while I'm baking cookies here. All right, what's our timer at? All right, it's almost 7 minutes. Yeah, we're definitely going to go a couple more minutes here. You're once late, you're usually bus stop like a minute. One guy died right there. Oh, my God. Jeez. How many people have I almost died stories? This is like on A&E, those, or Discovery Channel. The day I almost died. I don't know that I like these stories. It's too real. You found the video. Oh, God. I can't check that link over here, but I'm sure it's a... I hope it's funny if Shogi linked it. That's not a bus. That's a space station. Yeah, they're looking pretty good. I'm gonna go another 2 minutes. I think I can actually show you guys this time. All right, let's see if I can get the camera. This prepare for seasickness here. Let's see here. I don't know if you guys could see anything there. A wild ride. Looks amazing. They look pretty darn good, I gotta say. Seasickness Omega cookie. Did you see the Omega cookie? Yeah, they're all cooking right up next to each other. Looks like you're poop. Oh, well, Kenny, you must eat a lot of chocolate chip cookies then. That's all I gotta say. Those look pretty darn good. These are dairy-free cookies too. So if anybody's got any lactose issues, these cookies should not give your stomach any issues since there's no butter in it. You had a lot more money than you do if it looked like that. Okay, great. vegan cookies. They're not vegan, I don't think. Are they vegan? What is vegan? Just no animal stuff? No, it has eggs. So this is not vegan. It has eggs. Okay, I think one sheet is just about ready. Yeah, I think the Omega cookie is just about ready here. No, you weren't banned. You probably just did a link and got deleted since you weren't permitted. So you're trying to unban Kenny and the chat moved. Whoops. Hashtag ban everything. Hashtag ban the world. Okay, so I think the Omega cookie sheet is ready. Yeah. Okay, that's some big old Omega cookies right there. Okay. All right, let's put this on the cooling sheet, cooling rack, cooling Omega lol, I don't know. There we go. I think the other ones need another minute, maybe. All right. Cookie cake. Yeah, there's our cookie cake, guys. They all, like, just slowly melded into one giant cookie. I gotta say, I think these do look better than the last ones, just because extra chocolate. Just because extra chocolate. Looks amazing, though. Yeah, they're going to be good. What I might do is just leave them on the cooling rack. Cooling rack. I said the right thing this time. And just leave it for the entire stream and just let them cool here all day. I think if I let them cool and don't, like, immediately put them into a bag, they won't all, like, melt together. So you're always blown away for as long as Kenny's been here. He gets Ranbot banned as much as he does. Well, I tried to make him a mod, and he wouldn't accept it. All right, and there's the ones that I do in the little cake pan always are like little cookie towers. They don't spread out as much, probably because they're in a cake pan. I think the cooking time was better this time, too, because they're just a little brown on the edges, and I think they're going to separate a little better, be separated cookies. So here, give you guys a view of the cookie goodness. We got those guys, and then here is the mega monolith cookie here. Mega monolithic cookie. So what I'll probably do is have to cut those up or something. Hey, Danny Yep, what's up? What's up, Danny Yep? I figured out who I thought your name reminded me of yesterday. It was Donnie Yen. Is that who we said, Shogi, was in the It's the Ip Man movies. Donnie Yen and Ip Man. Those were the movies I was trying to think of the other day. How dare you even speak of cutting up your baby, huh? Those cookies are your baby? All right. I do have to have one cookie. It's just required that when you make cookies, you have to have one, so. What? Crap, there's a hair in there. Oh, there's a hair in my cookie. Thankfully, it's my hair. Cut them while malleable. Probably a pretty good idea. Let me get a little knife for that. I have a little tiny knife I was given by somebody. It's a good idea, Scaperio. Spectre. I'm sorry, Spectre. Thank you. Good idea. So we actually do have separated cookies. Delicious. Omega cookie needs cuts in them, huh? You've never heard of them? Well, Danny Yep, if you like martial arts movies, the Ip Man movies are really good movies. They're a little, I don't know, depressing? I don't know if depressing is the word, because it's like a bunch of Chinese people lose their jobs because the Brits come in, I think. Like the Brits come in and make all the Chinese people work. It's about him trying to, like, get bags of rice for fighting these people. Or maybe it's the Japanese that come in that make him work. I forget. There's always somebody oppressing Chinese people in those old martial arts Chinese movies, I feel like. Don't lick knives. Sorry. It was delicious, though. Casual stabbing of the inside of your mouth. Chocolate is a little melty. Okay, sorry, I was not a good example by licking a knife here. Okay, all right. We have separated cookies. We have successfully amputated cookies. All right. Donnie Yen is also Chirrut in The Last Jedi. Is that that guy's name? Yeah, he's the guy is the... I'm one with the Force, the Force is one with me, or something like that. What about sharp sauce? Don't need that. Swords are not excluded. Yes, don't lick your swords, unless you're... I'm going to get fatso, Rand. only lick swords if you're a crazy murderer guy who just went to war and killed a bunch of guys and is trying to, you know, freak out your opponent by licking the blood of your enemies off your sword. Okay, don't do that either. I read too many sci-fi fantasy books. Last Jedi or Rogue One? It's, oh yeah, it's Rogue One, isn't it? Because it's one that has no Jedi in it. And so, is it? I can't remember. Shogi knows movies better than me. You got fatter just looking at those cookies. All right, so we got to have one cookie to celebrate. Let's find a good one. There we go. Look at that cookie. Looks good. Rogue One, Shogi got it wrong. Oh, man. Yeah. It gets better than last time. Chocolate is melting on me, which is a good thing. I think cooking them just a little bit longer and adding a little bit extra chocolate. Okay, a lot of extra chocolate really did well. You can see the cookie. Chocolatey goodness. So good. Looks like the cookies we get in the co-op. They're really soft and taste amazing. Yeah. I love soft, chewy cookies. Those are my jam. Those are my favorite. Good stuff. These are going to be good cookie time cookies, let me tell you guys. I don't know. Anybody, any experienced bakers know if it's okay to just leave these out for the rest of the day, or should I bag them up? Is anybody experienced baker know if it's okay to just leave the cookies out drying in the air? Let my cookies air dry. They will last 2 days until fully eaten. I should put them in like Tupperware. You would say bag them. All right. Well, they're cooling off here, so I don't have Tupperware. Let me see if I have something I could put them in that's similar to Tupperware. I have more pans. I mean, maybe I could put them in like just this little metal, these little metal pans or something. Don't have a lot of supplies. I have these I have these plastic bowls. These plastic bowls might work. I think the pans would work fine too. The pan is going to be a little hot just from being on the stove. I think if I put them in these old bowls and cover them with Saran wrap, I think that'll work. So let me do that instead of just putting them in a bag where they all mash up together. All right. I want to do this not on top of the stove because the stove is freaking hot. So I guess I'll just hold this. Let me rinse this out. Need to get me some Tupperware. Keep them covered. Yeah, I'll cover them with I have plastic wrap. I can just cover it with plastic wrap. I think that'll work. Bowl of cookies. How would you like that for breakfast? Bowl of cookies. So stinking good, man. So proud of my cookies. They look delicious. Look at that bowl of cookies. Wouldn't you just eat those up, ma'am? No, keep them covered with your stomach. Just eat them. Sounds like a good plan. I will do that. Slightly slower to avoid fatness, hopefully. Wonder if I could fit them all in this one. Now we'll use two bowls. We will use two bowls. Gonna say, did I do any better on time? But no, it took us about an hour again. I feel like chatting with you guys while I make these. I can't really make these in less time. So, my God. Good cookies, though. My problem when I make good cookies, though, is that they're so good that I snack on them. So, I need to avoid snacking on them and just save them for GG cookie times, and that's all. Maybe too much chocolate. Sticking to the sheet because of chocolate. Who am I kidding? You can never have too much chocolate. Never have too much chocolate. You can make them in less time by buying them. This is true. And I do have some store-bought cookies, but I mean, but then I wouldn't if then I wouldn't be able to have this good time with you guys where we cooked cookies together. I think Pie Boy said he made some cookies yesterday. Get the little leftover piece on the sheet there. Okay. All right. Let me wrap these bowls up, and we'll be ready to play some Civ 5, guys. You should save your money and buy an African nation and use the people as your workforce to make cookies. You and the people can just eat cookies. You could simply export all the spare cookies for the money you need to bake more cookies. Wow. A never-ending cookie conglomerate. Amazing. Amazing. Okay, before I wrap them, I got to show them off. Look at the bowls of cookies. Bowls of cookies. I kind of want to take a picture and share them on Facebook. Like, this is what I did on my stream today. I'm actually going to do that real quick. I'm going to be one of those losers on Facebook who post what they do. 1 second. I'm going to be one of those losers who shares their food they make. All right, let me take a picture real fast. Share them on Instagram. Share them on Twitter. Share them on all the things. How do I make it flash? Flash. Nice. I will share this later. I'll probably even share it on my Rand118 Twitter too. Instagram is where you put food pics. All right, I'll post them. I'll post them everywhere. Okay, everywhere. I'll post them on Twitch, on YouTube. We're just gonna put these everywhere. Everyone deserves to see these cookies. This is the world is a better place for more cookie pics, right? All right, just cover these up. You follow me on Twitter just to look at the chocolate chip cookies? I don't blame you. Don't blame you. Foot pics there. Food and foot. Like athlete's foot pics? I don't know. Okay. Will you stay covered? I guess so. That should kind of work. I think I should probably get some Tupperware. Guarantee if you post a pic of the cookies on Tinder, everyone would swipe right for you. My profile pic on all of my dating apps is just going to be a pile of chocolate chip cookies. I don't know. I feel like all of the large women would swipe right for me, and all the vegans maybe not so much. I don't know. I'd have to not use eggs. They would be vegan cookies to get the vegan ladies to swipe right. Then they would be surprised and saw he doesn't look like the pic. Hey, you're not a cookie. You're just some guy. Oh my God, I thought I was going on a date with a bowl of chocolate chip cookies, man. I am so misled. I'm reporting you for misleading picture on Tinder. Alrighty. Alright, so we have turned a bunch of random ingredients into two bowls of chocolate chip cookies. I like it. We even got more than two dozen this time. TBH, the vegans would probably still swipe right as they'd be converted. All right, guys, real quick, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the loading screen so I can move stuff around, get situated for playing video games here. So give me just a couple minutes while I do that. I will turn on music and song requests so you can request music while I get this reset up. Thank you all again so much for hanging out. We're going to swap over to Civ 5. Give me like 3 or 4 minutes to get set up. You guys are awesome. Be right back, guys.